Hey everyone, welcome back to another Red Dead Online video. Now in today's video, we're going to be going over the three things that we go over on the channel each and every single day. Those three things include all the daily collection sets and their current cycles. We're going to go over the daily general challenges in extensive detail. And then last but not least, we're going to go over Madame Nazar's location. But anyway, let's go ahead and get started. But before we actually do that, I do have a question for you, but I'll ask that question at the end of the video. So if you guys would like to stay tuned for that, make sure you guys stick around till the very end. But anyway, we got the fossils, which will be a part of cycle number 6. The lost jewelry at cycle number 3. Arrowheads at cycle number 4. Family heirlooms, cycle 6. Coins at cycle number 3. American wildflowers at cycle 4. Tarot cards, cycle 6. We have antique alcohol bottles, cycle 2. And bird eggs, cycle 1. Well, apparently that's one of the daily challenges for today, visiting Fort Mercer. Well then, all right, okay. Let's go ahead and move on to the daily general challenge, or the daily general challenges, and we're going to go over those into detail. Obviously, where is it at? There it is. Visiting Fort Mercer and then visiting Fort Wallace. So I guess I can show you guys. Oh, was that a boy mission completed too? Where are these all? Okay. Wow. All right. So Fort Mercer, obviously, you're down here in the New Austin area. So I'll show you guys exactly where it's at, just in case you don't know. It's pretty well labeled. And then Fort Mercer is actually going to be up in north. It's going to be north of Valentine. Right up there is where you guys want to be able to go to. And then the boy mission will typically either be in Valentine, so right in this location there, right above the N, or down at the Flatneck Station. It all depends on where you guys are currently at. That's where the boy will be at for his mission. The next thing on the list is going to be one player kill from the hip in a free roam event. So Cold Dead Hands, Railroad Baron, Dispatch Rider, something like that. Obviously, Railroad Baron, Dispatch Rider are going to be a little bit harder just because you're going to be on a horse. There are a couple other PvP ones that you guys can go in and participate in. It does not matter what weapon you use or if you use explosive rounds or anything like that. Just get a, just don't aim. That's all you basically need to do for that one. Place top three in a takeover series. So you actually do have to place top three if you're not that good at PvP or just don't like PvP like myself. I did for the first time try PvP in like 4 to 5 months and I hated it. I didn't even honestly get the daily challenge that I wanted to get, and I was done. I actually don't even think I finished it. I played about half of it, and I'm like, this is so ridiculously stupid, and I moved on. 5 feathers sold. It could be whatever feathers you want, specific feathers, so like heron feathers or egret feathers or whatever, or it could just be flight feathers. Whatever you guys prefer, whatever you have on you, just sell those to any of the butcher locations. The other one is going to be 4 coyotes skinned. So coyotes can be found anywhere. New Hanover has a lot of them. New Austin, where I'm currently at, has quite a few of them as well. Any of them will actually work. Just go ahead and kill 4 of them and then go ahead and skin them. That looks like that's pretty much all of the daily general challenges. Looks like most of these are fairly easy, except for probably the Takeover Series Showdown 1. Moving on to the Bounty Hunter role, we have one bounty hunt completed without killing any enemy or bounty target. 2 bounty targets tagged with tracking arrows, 3 eagle eye used to track a bounty target. The trader role, 3 camp stews eaten, a distance of 15,830 by delivery wagon traveled on a mission, 2 goods sold to a distant buyer. Collector role, we have 3 collectibles found with a shovel, 3 collectibles looted from non-player enemies, 3 fossils found. Before we actually continue on anymore, I do want to let you guys know that if you guys do have questions on anything that we go over in today's video, or don't even go over, and if you have other daily rule challenges that you guys need help with, go ahead and leave a comment down below so that either myself or someone else in the community can definitely go ahead and help you out, especially if you guys are new. We want you guys to feel welcome and get as much knowledge and information that you need to get whatever you need done and completed. The Moonshiner roll, we got 1 completed special Moonshine recipe, 2 Moonshine bar drunken player interactions, 3 Moonshine bootlegger missions completed. And before we move on to the Naturalist roll, I'm going to show you guys where you can find Madame Nazar for today. And Madame Nazar is actually going to be located just in the Bulger Glade area. She was actually here just the other day, but that will make Rhodes your fast travel destination of choice. Just head a little bit southeast and you'll be able to find her right here at the Civil War battlefield location. All right, and then last but not least, we have the Naturalist roll. We have 5 animal samples sold to Harriet, 7 crafted or cooked at a wilderness camp, and then 2 legendary animal samples taken. That is everything done, gone over, and covered in today's episode. If you guys did enjoy, you know what to do. But my question is do you guys just want me to list the numbers or whatnot with the daily or with the collection sets every single day like I did earlier? Do you want me to kind of go over it a little bit more in detail? And the same thing with the Daily Geno challenges. Do you want me just to list them, or do you want more information on them like I have been giving in the past few episodes? Let me know in the comment down below. But if you guys enjoyed, don't forget to like and subscribe and let YouTube know that you guys much appreciated it. But until next time, YouTube, you guys keep doing what you're doing because you're already doing it. And you guys, stay gaming.